You are so cheap.
Breaking the mold. Radioactive 247. Invasion is coming.
At this point in time, we know of only one method of killing the creatures, or destroy the brain.
Something old and something new.
Be on the guard of any loved ones who may have recently been in any sort of contact with these that I contacted.
Coming to Radioactive.
Please, do not hesitate to act.
The again, Metal Invasion.
This is not a joke.
The Metal Music Invasion. Is nightly from 10 p.m. to 3 a.m. Mountain Standard Time.
Oh my God, they're everywhere.
The cure for the radio infection. Radioactive 24/7.
We are outnumbered.
Sometimes radio stations sound like that annoying barista.
What can I get you?
I'd like a large coffee.
Okay, so hot coffee?
Hot coffee.
Okay, room for cream?
Totally leave room for cream.
Why are you talking like that?
Why are you talking like that?
It's the same boring talk or music station day in and day out.
No, it's not. I heard you talking a minute ago. I know you don't talk like that.
Neither do you, because nobody actually talks like this. Pretty annoying, isn't it?
No annoying talk. No format, no rules. Music, news, and information.
Why are you so rude, man?
Just stop doing that.
Can't help it. It's my voice.
No, it's not.
The cure for the radio infection.
So just because I talk like this?
That's an excellent question to ask yourself in your actual voice.
Excuse me.
Radioactive 24/7. The cure for diverse people.
There you go. Good.
Some of us would like to order.
Hey, Chris from the night shift.
He really has some trouble with reality. Have you ever thought of a new line of work? No format, no rules. Radioactive 24/7.
Just stop doing that.
Obviously, somebody forgot to lock the cages.
Lower the curtain down in this.
Chris and the Night Shift.
What's it like to live with yourself?
I see the counseling is not working. Wouldn't you start twitching again? You could use a makeover.
Everything's so
like it's time for your injection again. Radioactive 24/7, the cure for the radio infection.
So there's certainly a number of people who have been convinced, coerced, essentially brainwashed into
Ashley and the Day Shift.
Part of a cruel medical experiment.
This next song is going out to Chelsea, who's been getting a little salty for not knowing all this kid lingo. That's Cap. Ashley here with you.
Lay low for a while because you probably wanted
diverse music for diverse people.
But I believe diversity is an old, old word.
wooden ship that was used during the Civil War era.
Freaking idiot.
Well, I could be wrong,
but nice try.
Turn it up so I can feel it. Turn it up so I can be near it. Baby says she's got that feeling. Moonwalking on the ceiling. It's alright. It's alright. It's alright. It's alright. Alright.
Ashley with you until 6 p.m.
Dings the nostrils.
Coming up this hour, Ron from YouTube and Rock and Metal News. Diverse music for diverse people. Radioactive 24/7.
Rain, rain on my face. Hasn't stopped raining for days. My world is a flood. But slowly I become one with the mud.
Diverse music
for diverse people.
Radioactive 24/7, the cure for the radio infection. Chris here with you.
When did you start twitching again?
Generally after I listen to Ashley in the day shift from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m.
Your mind is rent-free.
Well, I prefer the term discounted. It's springtime heading into summer, and you know what that means? More summer concerts. Go to our information section on our website to find out the concerts coming near you.
I see the counseling is not working.
My self-esteem counselor warned me about people like you. Radioactive 24/7, good to have you along. Coming up this hour, Rock and Metal News with Ron from YouTube.
Radioactive 24/7. Ashley here with you. Make sure to not tune into the Metal Invasion weeknights with Chris from 10 to midnight.
Complete mindless nut job.
It might be a little scary for you due to the fact that he needs a stronger prescription.
My mom always told me about God. I think I had an idea that God was big and good, but as time went on and I saw more and more tragic things happen around me, I think that was the beginning of me just questioning everything about life and about God. I remember thinking that same year that my cousin died about the depth of the evil in the world. I never wanted to have kids. It was just a new person to suffer. That was the year I started to cry myself to sleep every night and stopped believing in God. I couldn't get away from my own depression. So I started studying other religions. There was a lot of nice ideas, but there wasn't any tangible healing. And I remember thinking, I'm tired of the pain in my heart. I'm tired of going to bed that way. I'm tired of feeling like a burden. I'm just tired of not knowing why I'm alive. And so I remember the night I laid in bed and I knew I was going to commit suicide the next day. I knew that I was not going to live past tomorrow. On the day that I planned to commit suicide, I came home from school and my grandma was there and she wasn't supposed to be there. And she looked at me and said, "There's something wrong with you. You're gonna go to church." I was like, "No way I'm going to church." And she screamed at the top of her lungs like we were fighting back and forth, and I just didn't want to listen to her yell anymore. And so I decided, fine, I'll go. And then afterwards, I'll go ahead and follow through with my plan. So I went to the back of the church and slumped down in my chair and hated everybody in the room. And the pastor started speaking, and I hated him more than anyone. And he says, "There's a suicidal spirit in the room." And of course, all the hair stood up on the back of my neck, and I was, "Well, this is really weird." And I got up and went to the door. A white-headed man is standing there, and he stopped me. And it was like, "The Lord wants me to speak to you. He wants you to know that even though you've never known an earthly father, that God will be a better father to you than any earthly father could ever be. God knows the pain in your heart. He has seen you cry yourself to sleep at night." The idea was so overwhelming to me. He's like, "Do you want me to pray for you so that Jesus can take the pain out of your heart?" He put his hand on my shoulder and started to pray. It was as if the God of the universe showed up right in front of me. And the first thing I noticed was that God was holy and good. And the second thing I noticed was that I was so not holy and not good. If God had looked at me and said, go away forever, he would have been right. It would have been just as... The same time I felt that, I felt him inviting me to an embrace of grace and love unconditional. It was like God was saying, I love you. I know you're tired of the way you've been living, and I will make you new if you will let me. My heart was just yes. It just said, yes, I need that. I want that. Please. And that's why I woke up the next day. I just felt such a peace and a joy almost that I'd never felt before. Jesus saved my life. And on top of everything else, the life of my son and the new baby. That wouldn't be if Jesus hadn't intervened and rescued me.
Infection.
60% of the time, it works every time.
Radioactive 24/7. Chris here with you.
You're disappointing me, Chris.
Recently, I saw a disturbing thing. Ashley, 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. every day for the day shift.
It might be a little scary for you. Are we going to get arrested for this?
Into this room at your own risk, because it leads to the future. Not a future that will be, but one that might be. This is not a new world. It is simply an extension of What began in the old one, since the beginning of time, it has refinements, technological advances, and a more sophisticated approach to the destruction of human freedom.
You're listening to The Metal Invasion on Radioactive 24/7. Brought to you by Rentokill of North America, Vado Clothing Company in Fort Collins, and The Human Beam in Northern Colorado.